Hello, welcome back. This is my first video post-quarantine lockdown here in Moscow on Novi Arbat, New Arbat, on a special day. It's Victory Day, the day where the Russians defeated the Nazis in World War II. It's a beautiful day, beautiful sunny day, a little bit festive in the air, people lining the streets to watch a parade. I don't know if there's any parade here, but I'm going to head to the Red Square. I'm already late. It started at 10. It's probably 10 past 10 a.m. at the moment. Let's see if I can see anything there. Otherwise, it's going to be a great day just to have a walk, just to have a look. People riding bikes. Military men lining the streets. I don't know why, but over the past few nights, there have been tank rehearsals on this street, so it was kind of cool to watch. Here, walking towards the other end of New Arbat Street, where the crowds are getting thicker, probably because I'm heading towards the Red Square, where the main parade is. I have a feeling the parade will be coming down this street at some point. Hence all the people who couldn't get a spot at the Red Square, but you know, I'm gonna make my way there. I'm gonna see if I can find a spot to have a look at something. A lot of families around, people just chilling. I guess everyone's hoping to see something interesting. Right now on the street it's just regular traffic, not as much as usual, probably because it's a public holiday today, but I think at some point they're just gonna stop the local traffic and have the parade come down through here. I've just passed Novi Arbat, New Arbat Street. The crowds are thicker here. I'm assuming people want to see the parade because I cannot get to the Red Square. I don't think I'm going to reach there either. I mean, look at it. It's just filled up. Yeah, maybe this is the best spot right now. Mind you, this area is nowhere near as crowded on a normal night. And yet, women giving out masks for the coronavirus every few meters, which is good. And look, I don't even think I can go down my usual way. It seems blocked off, so I can either go around or stay here. I don't know, staying here is pretty good, but I really want to be at the Red Square. Just walking down the back streets, try and get to the main street, perhaps Tverskaya, Ulitsa, but I'm heading towards another crowd. Hopefully I can inch my way forward, but I might have to turn around. I think worst comes to worst, I'm gonna retreat back to the end of Novi Arbat, and hopefully I can see something from there. I mean, this wouldn't be a bad place. There's lots of shade, it's quite cool. Seeing as it's quite hot in the sun at the moment, I think it's mid-20s. In terms of temperature, yeah, I'm blocked off here. So there's nowhere else to go. Yeah, I think I'm just going to turn around and loop around to the red square. To the right is the red square, but I think this might be as far as I can get. I mean, it doesn't look like there's any other way. Everything has been blocked off. Maybe it's only the official stuff happening at Red Square. Everyone at home and on the streets is watching the official parade on their cameras. Pretty much nothing to see here. Yeah, I think I might go back to Novi Arbat then, because there's much more atmosphere there. You know what? I see some people walking up these stairs, I'm going to follow them. I might be able to get to the main street, Tverskaya Ulitsa. So let's see if there's anything up these stairs. Yep, the stairs just led to another dead end. I really should have looked up the layout for this parade. But that's what you get up for waking at 10 a.m. when the parade starts at 10 a.m. Oh, I just heard some horns. I think the vehicle parade just started. I can see some tanks and green vehicles behind the wall of vehicles there. So I think the parade is getting started, or the vehicle parade. So I'm going to try and rush back to Novi Arbat, where I can get a good view. Lots of people, good atmosphere. Well, after a 15-minute walk, I've headed back to Novi Arbat. You can see a big sign there, 9th of May, which is the actual date of V-Day, which is obviously postponed due to the coronavirus. So everyone's hoping to see something, I think. Yeah, just what I thought. The local traffic has been cut off, so for sure they're going to get ready for the army vehicles. Someone even brought their own ladder. Always be prepared. Everyone's moving. Seems like the first tanks are coming. Let's check it out. Yeah. Oh, we got missiles now.
Thank you.
funnily enough, the best views seem to be back where I started. A lot more empty space. Okay, it's been a couple of hours since the parade. Streets are back open, traffic is flowing. I can freely walk to the Red Square. So I'm just gonna walk through Alexander Garden, turn left, and I'm gonna hit the Red Square pretty soon. I think this is probably the busiest I've ever seen this kind of area. So people must have just stuck around after the parade just to enjoy the day, the weather. See people carrying caps. I can safely say for sure that pretty much every family in Russia and part of the Soviet Union was affected by this war, so it's a very interesting atmosphere to be here. People are very respectful. Yeah, people are just really respectful just because they have serving in the army. And if you do know history, I lost quite a few people in the war. So I'm heading towards this kind of eternal flame memorial thing. I'm not exactly sure what it is. I've been here many times, but just not sure what it is. But I like it. There's a change of guard every hour. Oh, this is pretty cool. Youngins learning from the seniors.
Сейчас медаль еще, значит, там, земельная. Мы добиваемся, Свердловской земли, добиваемся, чтобы реализовали представление. Представление написано по горячим следам. Там есть минуты и минуты написано, когда он будет.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. You get even young people sticking around showing their respects, you know. No one's rude here about this day. Here at the Eternal Flame Memorial. I mean, the change of guard won't be done until another 15 minutes. But maybe this kid's gonna go fetch his boys. I'm not gonna really stick around for it. I think I've had another video about it earlier on. So I'm just gonna keep walking. I'm gonna check out Red Square, which is here. I mean, this whole area was on TV this morning in an official ceremony with Putin marching up and just placing roses on the kind of monuments at each interval, starting from the Eternal Flame. Very interesting stuff. It's probably more interesting watching it on TV because all the cameras had the best angles, but you know, there's something different about being in the crowds, being in the stand.
Приобретаем билеты на теплоход.
I mean, there's a couple of ways I can go into the Red Square. I'm just gonna go my favorite way because I think this way is mine. Looks to be blocked. Yeah, it definitely is blocked. Let's just go through here. I'm gonna go around the front of this epic statue, a great general of Russia. I think it was Zhukov, or I can't really pronounce his name or even remember it, but yeah, it probably says it in front here. Zhukov. That's it. '41 to '45. Victory Day. I think I can't even enter the Red Square. I mean, this side is blocked off as well. They're probably just cleaning up after the official events. But anyway, we're here. Well, at least I'm here. I really like the atmosphere. People are just out. It's in the evening now. I'm here at Victory Park, Pebody Park, on V-Day in Russia. In the morning, I saw on the streets of Novi Arbat a victory parade. Now I'm here at Victory Park, where there's a victory museum dead straight ahead. It's really crowded today. I was hoping it would be crowded, and it is. Cool. It's pretty epic here. Wide spaces. Let's check out these monuments. I take it there's something over that hill. Probably check out later in a bit, but let's check this out.
Уважаемые москвичи и Ну вот я напротив.
So apparently here in this park there's a Jewish synagogue, an Orthodox Christian church and a Muslim mosque. That's pretty neat. I can definitely see the Orthodox church from here, which is behind there. I'm going to also go look for the synagogue and the mosque. I think it's going to be interesting. There's a church. I'm gonna head there in a bit. You know, I was here back in winter and it was totally empty because it was pretty much the dead of winter and it was freezing. But tonight it's a cool low 22, I think it is. Now this pillar here is just truly epic. It's so freaking tall. I don't know if my camera can capture it up close. Okay, we're pretty much at the base of the pillar. There's a giant statue of Saint George, knighted warrior on a horse killing the dragon. And I didn't realize that this pillar had so much detail in there. It's not a blank pillar, an obelisk. There's tons of detail, but unfortunately you can't go up. There's the head of the dragon, Saint George. You can see the pillar in the background. I think you can make out some of the detail on camera. I can't actually zoom, so you can't tell. And he's just freaking tall. Maybe down here you can see the detail a little bit. Yeah. That is very cool. Of course you got the flowers, paying respects at the front. And there's a view of Moscow City in the background. It's about a 20-minute bus ride from Novi Arbat, from where the parade was in the morning. So, great. Alright, here I am at the church. I'm going to try and go around, see if there's anything, see if there's anything interesting. It doesn't look open, but just incredible details. Let's have a loop around. Hopefully there's something. Another St. George. They love St. George in Russia. Oh, it's definitely closed. I can see inside. This pie, all of this in front is essentially a park. A freaking huge park. I haven't even explored it all. It's just too big. Look at the monument. Ooh, secret stairs up to ring the bell. I don't think I'm gonna tempt fate and ring the bell, but see if we see there's anything in through the window. No, can't see anything at all. Not gonna even try. There it is. The church. Now I just gotta tick off the mosque and the synagogue. So from the church, I'm walking down an alleyway which is kind of situated in the park I was talking about, but when you're here it actually feels like you're in a forest. I'm sure if you can capture it properly, but just a real thick Russian forest. Hopefully the camera's picking it up. But, oh, that looked close. But yeah, I'm walking to the synagogue, and from the synagogue I'm gonna head towards the mosque. So a pretty cool atmosphere now. It's getting kinda cool, kinda chilly in the evening. Looks like there's another monument here on the left. Yeah, definitely epic. Epic. There's just so much detail in this artwork. Chiseled in stone. That's really cool. And there's the actual monument. This one's pretty cool. Yep, and you know, Victory Day, it's about crushing them Nazis. Alright, continuing down the alleyway, have arrived at the synagogue. Wasn't sure what it was, at first, but considering the Star of David is on top of this building, I'm gonna safely assume is the synagogue. I'm gonna do a lap, see what happens. But don't think there's gonna be anything special. It's really cool. There's this building thing here and a pathway that leads into the park, which is pretty much a forest. Yeah. And it's a shame I'm not able to enter into this building. I'm probably a few hours too late. I would think they would be open today. I mean, considering it's a victory day and these three places of worship were built in honor of the dead. Here's their candle thingy. Can't remember what it's called. But you know when you see it. And some Hebrew inscriptions that I can't read at all. If it was in Russian, I could read it, but Hebrew, I cannot. Yeah, I really don't know much about synagogues. Haven't had much experience in them. I don't even know if this is traditional style or Soviet era style. Don't know. Oh. Hey Jude. So, from the Jewish synagogue, I've walked around to the Muslim mosque. I like it. Again, it's not open, but it's quite impressive. Check out this gate kind of thing. I don't know if the camera's picking up, but there's a lot of intricate patterns. Oh, you can actually go in. Oh, this seems to be the only one that's open. Or maybe that guy just got kicked out. I wasn't paying attention. I'm assuming that's the tower where the call to prayer is done. Wow. You know, I've never actually been in a mosque that wasn't a tourist site. But I would like to check it out one time. See all the patterns? Yeah. Reminds me of India a bit. Yeah, I don't know if there's much to see around. There's the moon. I'm gonna go in. My friend who was with me is just whispering me to go in. So maybe I can go in. Hopefully it's not disrespectful to bring a camera, but you know, I'll switch it off if I need to. Do I keep hat on or off? I have no idea. I'm gonna take my hat off. So they pretty much asked me if I wanted to pray. I said no, so I'm just gonna sit.
Hello,
So just to catch you up, it was really cool. I went inside the mosque and the security guard let me actually sit inside and observe people praying and shoot some video. So that was really nice of him. I didn't know what to expect, but it was very cool. All right, I tried to get to the university for the fireworks. I caught this bus, but there was so much traffic, it was blocked. So against official bus policy, the bus just stopped and let us out so we could have a look at the fireworks. We're gonna try and cross the street for a better view. It's just crazy traffic. Victory Day fireworks! Hell yeah! I was really trying to get on top of the hill to check out. Apparently, you can see the skyline of the city. Let's just keep walking, and then when we get there, we get there. It's still pretty good from here, huh?
Exactly. Huge.
Even here is a pretty good view.
Yeah, this
a lot of people have just stopped what they're doing to watch the fireworks. I don't know if you can see the people.